Good morning, friends. Welcome back to the class of user interface design again. So in the previous video we were discussing about navigation system. So in today's class we are going to understand the various components associated with web navigation systems. The first component is a link. Okay, to move between website information fragments necessitates the creation of navigation links. Okay, so other than links there are many other objects which we can use to navigate from one site or from one page to another page. However, the most important component is a link. To move between website information fragments necessitates the creation of navigation links. A link functions as a menu choice that, when selected, results in the connected information being displayed or results in a file being opened or downloaded. Okay, so if I click on a link, either I go to the next page, or I go back to the previous page, or I go to any other page, or I can totally go out to some other website itself, or I may download a video, or I may upload a video, or I mean not only video, any other file. Okay, in addition to being the critical component in web navigation, links give the user an idea of what a website, document or page is all about. Okay, so to begin, several guidelines associated with links are: the first one is, all navigation control must make sense in the absence of site context. We have to understand, all navigation controls must make sense in the absence of site context. Be continually available. Okay, be obvious and distinctive. So hope you are understanding this. Make sense in the absence of site context. So okay, so we should use a meaningful names to those links. Okay, the when the user reads that link, he should understand what exactly is. We should use a general names. Okay, not very site application specific names. Okay, otherwise what happens is the user may not understand. So that is what is the absence of site context. Okay, what exactly the link should be understood without or the absence of a site context. The links must be continually available. Links must be obvious and distinctive. Be consistent in appearance, function and ordering. So all the links should look the same. Okay, and you should follow some ordering. Okay, possess a textual label or description. So link should have a label. Okay, that too of a textual label or description. Offer multiple navigation paths. So links also should offer multiple navigation paths, more than one navigation paths. The first one is sensible. Okay, all navigation controls in the absence of site context must make sense to the user. Okay, so simply the user may have lost the context, or the page or website may have been entered from almost anywhere. The user can enter from anywhere. So that is what I told you. You should have a very good label available. All navigation controls must be easy to access, obvious and distinctive. A navigation link or control must look like a navigation control. Its appearance to the user must immediately suggest that it is an entry to be clicked or otherwise selected. So you can just go through the same information is provided here. Then browser command buttons hide the split between the browser and the website application by including a navigation control within the application. So we should make the user not to use any browser buttons. Okay, instead, whatever functionalities are provided in the browser, we should try to incorporate all of them in our application, so that we can avoid some sort of confusion to the user. Okay, user should not wander between the browser and the website. Okay, try to hold the user within our website itself. Then website navigation bars. Provide a global navigation bar at the top of each page. Okay, so every page should have a global navigation bar. Okay, so most of the websites, I think I will just show you. I have opened IIT Bombay's website. You can see here, we are discussing about. So this is about students, this is about the faculty, this is about media, this is about alumni, this is about industry. So this is what is that? A global navigation bar. It is called as a global navigation. So, we will just see. Provide a local category or topical links navigation bar on the left side of a page. However, you can see they have given in right side. So you can clearly see they have mentioned here related navigation. Okay, so they have provided on the right side. In fact, it should be on the left side, even it looks good. Okay, so we may have to tell the IIT people to incorporate these changes. Place a minor illustrative, parenthetical or footnote links at the end of the page. So let us see whether they have put something here. No, they you could see here education, research, site map. That is what we were discussing. Feedback. That is what. Okay. So for example, now you see. Now you see a quick find is provided here. Okay. So now it got opened. I think. Yeah. So even if I click on. Okay. On their Indian Institute of Technology, again it goes to the home. So these are the multiple ways of going back. Okay, so you see research, R&D. okay, so again at the bottom you could see old website, feedback, RTI, contact us. Everything is given there. For long pages, provide a navigation bar repeating important global or local links at the page bottom. So that is what they have done at the page bottom. So we will go to some other page and see. For example, academic divisions. Okay, so I came here. Suppose, okay, so still you could see about you can go back to these are different ways of representing the navigation. Okay, so now you see, so you could see home. Okay, in home you have come to academic division. So it is clearly mentioned here. Okay, a website navigation bar is a menu and an array of textural phrases, graphical images or icons or command buttons as illustrated in figure. A website navigation bar, so figure 4.13, figure 4.13, you could see here. So that is how it is a textural explicit listing navigational bar. So this is a navigational bar. So this is a graphical or iconic navigation bar. So you could see they have used some icons to represent. Okay, then command button navigation bar. So they, instead of showing the pictures or a text, they have presented command buttons here. So these are the different ways of presenting the navigation bars. Okay, so then you can go through the rest of the information, okay, which is available here. Yeah, that is what we were discussing about this here. This side it is a global links, this side it is a local links. So for example, this side it is a global link, these are the global links, and these are the these are local links. Okay, local links. Then textual phrases, provide a mix of textual phrases, links in explicit menus embedded within page text. Generally, yeah, most of them are textual links only. Student, so student is a text, right? Faculty is a text again. So these are the textual links only in explicit menus embedded within a page. So they are embedded within page text. Then graphical images or icons. graphical images or icons may appear in an array in the form of a navigation bar or be individually located at relevant points in a page. Okay, so you can use the graphical images. Then similarly, you can use the buttons. Just now we saw command buttons may appear in an array in the form of a navigation bar. Okay, some other website navigation elements we will be discussing in the next video. Thank you.